In the school days, you all are studied about that four fundamental operations. That is addition. First one is addition, second one is subtraction, third one is multiplication, and fourth one is division. Okay, you all are studied, right? Addition you studied, subtraction you studied, multiplication you studied, and division you studied. In this multiplication, addition, subtraction, and division, some of the properties are holds. It means it is a commutative property, associative property, and it is in the natural number and integers and whole numbers and everything you studied. So the main features of these operations is that given any two numbers A and B, we have to check it now. Okay, so I have to take it that A and B are the two numbers. We associated another number A plus B or A minus B or A into B or A divided by B. But A divided by B is B should not be 0. Clear. Should not be 0. Okay. So these are the terms. This is what addition, this is subtraction, this is multiplication, and this is what division. And these addition, multiplication, subtraction, and division are the examples of binary operations. These are the examples of what? Binary operations. So the binary operation, binary means it is what? Two. Binary means it is two. Okay. So binary operation, the definition of the binary operation is a binary operation, okay, star. So we are denoted by what? It is what? Star. Star means either it is a positive, it means addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So all the terms are there. On a set A is a function. So this is what is related to function, relation and functions. No, this is a function star from A cross A into A tends to A. Okay, so we denote that. So how can you denote this? Star of A comma B is by A star B. So we have to denote this what? A star B. Okay, so the binary operation is a star on a set A is a function star from A to A, A cross A to A. Then star is a what? A star B. We have to check it. Whether it is a addition or subtraction or division or multiplication, it should be whole. So all the these are wholes, then only we can say it is what? Binary operation. So for example, in the natural number we have to check whether it is a binary operation or not. Okay, so we have to check whether it's binary or not in the natural number. So A plus B, if I want to check it, A plus B, A is what? 1 and B is what? 2. It is what? 3. 3 is belongs to what? Natural number, no? So this is what applies. Now A minus B, if I am taking A minus B, A is 1, B is 2, you will get minus 1. Minus 1 is belongs to natural number or does not belongs to natural number? Yes, it is. Does not belongs to natural number. So once it is is not belongs to that, then this is called as not a binary operation. This is what? Not a binary operation. Suppose if you are considering any real number, so any real number, we can check A plus B is also a holds, and A minus B is also a holds, A plus B is holds, A minus B is holds, A into B is a holds, and then A divided by B is also a holds. Why? B is not equals to 0. B is not equals to 0. But B here in the R, B is equals to 0 also there. So this one is does not holds. Therefore, this is also not a binary operation. But one condition, it should be there. One condition, it should be there. What is the condition in that real number? Real number, it should not be a zero. Non-negative terms. You have to consider this word. Non-negative. Then only we can say, non-zero real numbers. Sorry, it is not a non-negative. It is a non-zero. B is does not equals to zero. It should be. If you are taking A and B belongs to R, B is equals to zero. No, so A divided by zero is not possible. Therefore, this is not possible. But the condition it should be apply. What is that? R is non-zero real number. Then you can consider this is also a one of the binary operation. Okay, so if it is non-zero real numbers, then this is applied, this is also applied, and this also applied, and this also applied. Okay, so then only we can say this is our binary operation. Clear? I hope that all of you clear this binary operation now. Now, I will explain that exercise. Directly, I will go to that exercise. It's a very simple one. Exercise number 1.4. Okay, so determine whether or not each of the definition of star is given below gives a binary operation. In the event as star is not a binary operation, give justification for this. So now in the first question, first one I will explain now. So exercise number 1.4 I am taking. In the first one, exercise number 1.4, first one. In the first one, first question, on Z plus, star is defined. A star B is equals to what? A minus B. Z plus, what is this meaning of Z plus? Z plus means only the positive integers. Z plus means only the positive integer. So best example, you can take only the positive integer A equals to 1 and B equals to 2. A star B is equals to A minus B equals to 1 minus 2. This is equals to minus 1. Is it belongs to Z plus or is it does not belongs to Z plus? Yes, 1 by 2 is not belongs to Z plus. Therefore, star is not a binary operation. Therefore, star is not a binary operation. Clear? So this is a way you have to check. Star is not a binary operation. So now in the second one part, what we can take the second part. Second part is, once again it is what Z plus A star B. It is what Z plus A star B equals to AB. Yes, A star B equals to AB. This is our condition. AB. AB means Z is any one of the number you can take it. A is 2 and B is 3. So A star B equals to AB. It is equals to what? 2 into 3. It is 6. 6 is belongs to Z plus or not. Yes, 6 is belongs to Z plus. Therefore, star is a binary operation on Z. Okay. So now next is this is a real number, on real number. Third one is on real number. A star B equals to AB square. A star B equals to AB square. So any one of the example you take down here. So if A comma B is belongs to R. If A comma B is belongs to R, then AB square is belongs to R or not. If A and B both are any one of the term, it is R, then AB square is belongs to what? R only we are getting. Okay. So now therefore star is binary operation. This also binary operation. This also binary operation. And this is not a binary operation. So now next one is fourth one I will take now. Fourth one. So fourth one is on Z plus, A star B is equals to modulus of A minus B. On Z plus, A star B is equals to modulus of A minus B. Yes. So here also we can say for all A comma B is belongs to Z plus. Only the positive integers. So now A minus B is also belongs to Z plus or not? z plus. Why it is z plus? Only the modulus sign. Modulus sign is state that removing the negative sign. So all the positive answers we are getting. Therefore, what is the conclusion we can write? Star is a binary operation. Okay. Now next one more. Last one is a fifth one in that. How can you simplify z plus a star b is equals to a? A star b is equals to a. Is it a binary operation or not? Yes, it's a binary operation. So how can you say it is binary operation? A comma b is belongs to z plus, so only that positive integer. Then a star b equals to a. A is also a belongs to z plus. A is also belongs to z plus. No, therefore star is a binary operation. Okay, so in that first problem, only that first one is not a binary operation, then remaining all the are binary operation. Now I will check with the second one. Okay, for each operation star defined below, determine whether star is a binary or commutative or associative. So before that, I will say what is commutative and what is associative. So commutative means, earlier classes you studied, a plus b equals to a plus b equals to b plus a, then a minus b is not equals to b minus a. In some other cases we can apply it. Then a b equals to b a, so a by b is also a equal or not equal b by a. In the different conditions, in the real numbers, a by b is sometimes it is what equal. Okay, so this is what commutative property. And associative property means a star b star c equals to a star b star c, a star b star c. So this is what associative property. So now we have to if it is a, in the second problem, if the condition is a binary operation, then we have to check whether it is a commutative or associative. Okay, so in the first one question, on z it is not mentioned whether it's a positive or negative. On z, a star b equals to a minus b. So it is what? On z, a star b equals to a minus b. Now we have to check whether it is a binary operation or not. Yes, it's a binary operation. Why? For all a comma b is belongs to z, for all a comma b is belongs to z, and a star b is equals to a minus b is also belongs to z. Why? You know, so for example, if you are taking 1 and 2, 1 minus 2 is minus 1, minus 1 is belongs to z. Z is an integer, all the positive and negative integers. Okay, so this, therefore what we can say, thus star is a binary operation. Star is a binary operation. So clear, no? Star is a binary operation. Now we have to check whether it is a commutative or not. In general, so what we have to write? In general, when a comma b is belongs to z. In general, a comma b is belongs to z. A minus b is not equals to b minus a. A comma b is not equals to b minus a. So for example, 1 minus 2 equals to minus 1, 2 minus 1 equals to 1. These both are equal? No, it is not equal. Therefore, a minus b is not equals to b minus a. Then what is the condition we can give? That is, a star b is not equals to b star a. So a star b is not equals to b star a means star is not commutative. So clear, no? A star b is equals to b star a means it is commutative. Here it is not equal, so it is not a commutative. Now we have to check, it is associative. So how can I check the associative? There are three terms it should be. The condition is what? A comma b comma c is belongs to z. A comma b comma c is belongs to z. So it is a star b star c equals to a star b star c. So this is about associative property, you know that. Now we have to check it is LHS. So LHS equals to what? A star b star c. Right. A star B star C is here. A star B star C means this A star B can be written as A star B is given as A minus B. A star B is given as A minus B, then star C. A star B is given as A minus B star C. So now you can take this term as P and star C. So this can be taken as P and star C. This implies P minus C or not. This implies P minus C. In the place of A minus B, we have to take it as P. P star C means P minus C. So P is what? A minus B minus C. A minus B minus A. This is the word first one. You can take it. Now, next, RHS. So, check with the RHS now. RHS is what? A star B star C. So, this can be written as A star as it is, you write. B star C place, how can I write? What can I write? Tell me. Well, B star C is B minus C. I can write B star C is B minus C. Why it is B minus C? A star B is equals to A minus B is given. So B star C is B minus C. Now this can be written as Q, you take down. A star Q. A star Q. A star Q means A minus Q. So A minus Q means A minus of B minus C. A minus of B minus C is A minus B plus C. This is our second one. So now check whether it's a plus one and second one both are same. First one is A minus B minus C and second one is A minus B plus C. Here from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, LHS is equals to RHS or it is not equals to RHS. It is not equals to RHS. Therefore, star is not a associative. Star is not a associative. So clear children, this is one of the important problem. This question is asked in 2018. Okay. So now I'll move to that second one. And the second question. So second question is on Q. On Q. Okay. So A star B is equal to A B plus 1. On Q. On Q is what? So which number? You know that, right? So Q is a rational number. So now A star B equals to AB plus 1. Now we have to check whether it is a binary operation or not. Yes. For all A comma B is belongs to Q, then AB plus 1 is equals to what? A star B or A star B equals to AB plus 1 is belongs to Q only. Therefore, star is binary operation. Star is binary operation. So clear? Now star is binary operation. How? A, B plus 1. It means 1 divided by all the rational numbers. So it should be a rational number. Now we have to check with the commutative property. So now commutative property. For all A comma B is belongs to Q. For all A comma B is belongs to Q. The condition is what? A star B equals to A B plus 1. A B plus 1. And B star A equals to what? B A plus 1. A star B is A B plus 1. B star A is B A plus 1. B A plus 1 and A B plus 1 is both are same. A B plus 1. So these both are equal. Therefore, A star B equals to B star A. What is the condition? Therefore, star is commutative. Star is commutative. Clear? Okay, now we have to check commutative. Now we have to check with associative. Associative. Okay. So, associative is for all A comma B comma C is belongs to Q. Now, associative property states that A star B star C equals to A star B star C. Okay. So now I'm taking that LHS. LHS is A star B star C. A star B star C means A star BC. BC means BC plus 1. Here it is AB plus 1. So BC plus 1. Now A star, this can be written as what? P. It is what? A star P. A star means AP plus 1. a b plus 1. A of p is b c plus 1 plus 1. So now a b c plus a plus 1. So this is our first condition. A b c plus a plus 1. Okay. So now we can check with the RHS now. RHS. So RHS equals to a star b star c. A star b star c. A star b is a b plus 1. A b plus 1. Star c. Star c as it is, right? This can be written as what it is, what? Q. Q can be written as Q star c. It means Q c plus 1. Q c plus 1. Q is what? A b plus 1 into c plus 1. So it is a b c multiply a b c plus c into 1 is c plus 1. This is what second one. So now a b c and a b c plus a b c same, but a and c are different. Therefore it is LHS is not equals to RHS. So LHS and RHS are not equal. Therefore star is not a binary, sorry, associative. Star is not associative. Star is not associative. So I hope that all of you are clear for these problems. Now you can check the same way AB divided by 2. Okay. So on Q, this is what on Q only. A star B equals to AB divided by 2. So you can check whether it is a commutative or associative. So it is a first only. I will explain. I will say only that I will say AB divided by 2 is a binary operation, and AB divided by 2 and BA divided by 2 is also a commutative. And you will get the associative also. You check it whether you are getting or not. Okay. So the star is binary and commutative and associative. Okay. So now next problem, fourth one, I will explain to you on Z plus. That is very important. On Z plus, A star B equals to 2 to the power of AB. A star B equals to 2 to the power of AB. So we have to check whether it is a binary operation or not. Yes, for all a comma b is belongs to Z plus. Next, a star b equals to 2 to the power of a b, it is belongs to what? Z plus only. Why all the a and b are positive? 1 and 2 you take down. 1 into 2 is 2. 2 to the power of 2, it is what? Positive answer only we are getting. Therefore star is binary operation. Star is binary operation. Now we have to check with the commutative. So commutative. Commutative is for all a comma b is belongs to Z plus. Okay. For all a comma b is belongs to Z plus. Commutative is a star b equals to 2 to the power of ab. And b star a equals to 2 to the power of ba. So 2 to the power of ab and 2 to the power of ba both are equal. Therefore star is commutative. Star is commutative. Now we have to check with the associative. Okay. So associative. Associative. For all a comma b comma c is belongs to Z plus. So now a star b star c equals to a star b star c. Okay, so now LHS, you have to take it now. A star B star C, all the problems are same, similar type, you have to simplify it. 2 to the power of AB, A star B is 2 to the power of AB, so first I will simplify the bracket, then star C. So this can be written as what? P now. So P star C, P star C can be written as 2 to the power of BC. 2 to the power of p is this full, 2 to the power of 2 to the power of ab into c. 2 to the power of 2 to the power of ab into c. This is our first one. Next, RHS equals to a star b star c we are getting. A star as it is, you are right. B star c is 2 to the power of bc. Okay, so a star 2 to the power of bc. Now this can be written as q. It is a star q. A star q can be written as 2 to the power of aq. Q is nothing but 2 to the power of a into 2 to the power of bc. Okay, this is for 2. So now here 2 to the power of bc into a, here 2 to the power of ab into c. Is it both are equal? No, it is not equal. LHS is not equal to RHS. That implies star is not associative. Star is not associative. Okay. Now last fifth one now. Same on Z plus A star B equals to A to the power of B. A star B equals to A to the power of B. So we have to check whether it is a binary operation or not. Yes, Z plus for all A comma B is belongs to Z plus. Next, A star B equals to A to the power of B. For any example you can take it, this is belongs to Z plus only. Therefore, star is a binary operation. Yes, star is a binary operation. Clear? So when star is a binary operation, we can check whether it is a commutative or not. Firstly, I will explain all this procedure wise you have to write how I am written in the previous problems, you know, like that only you have to check. So now A star B equals to A to the power of B and A star B equals to A to the power of B and B star A equals to B to the power of A. A to the power of B and B to the power of A both are same? No, it is not same. It is not same. So once it is not same, what we can say? Commutative star is not. Star is not commutative. Star is not commutative. Okay. So now once star is not commutative, we have to check with the associative now. So associative is A star B star C. So A star B star C means here it is B to the power of C. Here this is what B to the power of C. Now A star B star C means A to the power of B to the power of C. This is our first one. Okay. So now A star B star C, it is A to the power of B star C is A to the power of B to the power of C. A to the power of B to the power of C. Okay. So now you can say whether it is a commutative or associative or not. Yes, it is not a associative. Is it associative? It is not a associative. Why it is not a associative? A to the power of B to the power of BC, this can be written as here. B to the power of C means B to the power of C. So now A is there here. A star BC. A star BC, how can we write A star BC? A star BC is A to the power of BC. AB to the power of C. So AB to the power of C means what? A to the power of BC we can write. Now this is what? A to the power of BC we are getting. So this is what A to the power of B to the power of C. But this is what A to the power of BC we are getting. So please see how it is getting. A star B to the power of C means A star B is A to the power of B. So now this is what B. Okay, this is full B. So A to the power of B to the power of C. We cannot take that bracket. So A to the power of B to the power of C we are getting. Now next here we will get, what is that? A star B is A to the power of B. And this is what C, A to the power of B to the power of C. So A to the power of B to the power of C means B into C we can write, A to the power of BC. Okay. So now star is what? Star is not associative. Star is not associative. So I hope that all of you clear now. Okay. Now last one in the second main, last one, sixth one. So sixth one. Condition is what? The condition is on r on r minus of minus 1. So including minus 1, excluding minus 1, not in a minus 1 is not including. Define that a star b equals to a divided by b plus 1. Okay, so this b is not, no, it should not be a minus 1. If it is a minus 1, it will become a divided by 0. It is not defined. Therefore, here we have to take minus 1 is not there. So, minus 1 is not there. So, now we have to check whether this is a binary operation or not. It is a binary operation or not. So, how can you say it is a binary operation or not? A star b equals to a divided by b minus b plus 1. A star b is going to be b minus 1 for a comma b is belongs to r minus 1. R minus of minus 1. Okay. So now a is r minus of minus 1 means a is not equals to minus 1 and b is not equals to minus 1. Okay, we cannot take a is not equal to minus 1 and b is not equal to minus 1. So, if here a is not equal to minus 1 and b is not equal to minus 1. Okay, so now star is a binary operation? No. Therefore, star is not a binary operation. Star is not a binary operation. Why star is not a binary operation? We can take a equals to minus 2. We can take a equals to minus 2 and b equals to what? B equals to 1 we can take. A can take it as minus 2 and b can take it as 1. So now a star b equals to what? Minus 2 divided by minus plus 1 then plus 1. It is minus 2 divided by minus 2 divided by 2. Minus 2 divided by 2. It is what? Minus 1. But minus 1 is not there. But minus 1 is not there. Here we can take it as a equals to minus 2 and b equals to 1. A star b means minus 2 divided by 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 minus 2 divided by 2 is minus 1. Minus 2 is not there in this set. Correct? R is not there. Therefore, it is a binary operation. No. So that it is star is not a binary operation. If star is not a binary operation, clearly we can say, what is that? This is not commutative and it's not associative. Okay, clear? So this is the way we have to simplify it. So be careful, children, when you are simplifying this associative property. So be careful, you have to simplify it. Now, consider a binary operation, the third question, consider a binary operation, this symbol on the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, defined by A upper tap B is minimum A comma B, write on the operation table of the operation cap. Okay, so we have to draw that operation table now. So here the condition is what? A cap B equals to minimum of A comma B. So minimum of A comma B. So we have to take the minimum of A comma B. So now we have to draw a table for this. In the table we have to take, so here it is what? Condition. The numbers are given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have to draw this table like this. This is what operation table we have to take. Okay. So now the condition is A cap B equals to minimum of AB. So now 1 comma 1. 1 comma 1 we can take. So which is a minimum? 1 is minimum in there. Now 1 comma 2. Which is minimum 1 comma 2, 1 is minimum. And now 1 comma 3, which is a minimum, 1 is a smallest number, minimum is 1. Then 1 comma 4, 1 is a small. 1 comma 5, 1 is a small. This over now. Now I am considering this one, 2. 2 comma 1, which is a small, 1 is smaller or 2 is smaller? Yes, 1 is smaller. Then 1, 2 comma 2, both are same, the 2 we can write. 2 comma 3, 2 smaller. 2 comma 4, 2 smaller. 2 comma 5, 2 smaller. Now I have to take this 3. 3,11 smaller, 3,22 smaller, 3,3 3, 3,4 3, 3,5 3. Next 4,11 smaller, 4,2 which 2, yes, 4,3 is 3, 4,4 is 4, 4,5 is 4. Now next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this is our table. So in third problem only we have to draw the table. This is the table. Understood? No? I hope that all of you clear for this. So very simple way we have to simplify it. Minimum of A comma B. So now next examples are there. We have to find the LCM and we have to take the table like HCF and all. So in that time we get to know how to write this. This is what the minimum one, the smaller number you have to write. Now fourth one, the table is given. Consider a binary operation star on the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 by the given following multiplication table is given. Compute 2 star 3 star 4 and this one, this is a table. Using the table, table is this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this table you have to use. Now for this first question, what is the first question in that? In that first question is compute 2 star 3 star 4 and 2 star 3 star 4. Okay. So now 2 star 3. First this one I will explain now. 2 star 3. So here 2 star 3. 2 star 3. 2 star 3 is belongs to that answer is 1. Okay. So I will write 1 now. I will write 1. In this place I can write 1. So now 1 star. This 4 is remaining. This 4. Okay. So 1 star 4. Here it is 1. Here it is 1. And this is star 4. So 1 star 4 is belongs to what? 1. So the answer is 1. Okay. So now in the second part, second question, 2 star, star I am writing as it is, 3 star 4. So check this column. Where is 3? 3 is here. Where is star? Star is here. Then where is 4? 4 is here. So these two are belongs to what? Which one? It is 1. Okay. So 3 star 4 is 1. It is given in the table. Now 2 star 1. Whatever 2 star 1, 2 is here, star is here, 1 is here. 2 star 1 is what? 1. So that answer is what? 1. First one is 2 star 3 is star 4 is 1 and 2 star 3 star 4 is also what? 1. So in the second question, star is commutative. We have to check. So we have to check whether the star is commutative or not. Yes. So you can see the principal diagonal of this table, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So principal diagonal of this table is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then the other elements are some 1, 1, same. Then 1, 2, here it is 1 and 1. The terms are what you can see it is what same. So commutative means if you are taking 3, 3 is 3 and 3, 3 is what 3. Okay, so 2,3 is what 1 and 3,2 is what 1. Clear? 2,3 is what 1 and 3,2 is also what 1. Okay, now 4,5 is 1. 4,5 is 1. What about 5,4? 5,4 is also 1. So both are same, no? Okay, so for example, second one we have to check whether it is 2,3. It means 2 star 3. 2 star 3 is what? 2 star 3. 2 star 3 is 1. And what about 3 star 2? 3 star 2 is also what? 1. So now both these two are equal, no? So 2 star 3 is equals to 3 star 2. It means what? Star is commutative. Star is commutative. So now compute 2 star third one in that. So whatever, not only this 2 star 3 and 3 star. So I given only that example. You can take any one of the terms. You will satisfy that answer. Okay. So now compute 2 star 3 star 4 star 5. Okay. So answer 2 star 3. What is the answer for 2 star 3? 2 star 3 it is what? 1. 1. Star as it is, right? Then 4 star 5. 4 star 5. 4 star 5 is also what? 1. So now 1*1. 1*1 is what? 1. So this is our answer. So using the table only, you have to write all these answers. So now question number 5. Let star be the binary operation on the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 defined by A star B is HCF of A and B. Is the operation star dash is same operation as star defined in the exercise 4 above the table. Justify our answer. Okay, so that is what HCF of A and B. A star B is HCF of A and B. So now we have to make one more table of A star dash. Okay, in that star dash, A star dash B is what HCF of, is what HCF of A and B. A star dash B is what equals to HCF of A and B. So now A and B is for all A comma B is belongs to the terms which and the set 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. So now I'll make a table, star dash table I have to draw now. This is what HCF. Condition is what HCF. How we'll get that HCF you can see now. Star dash 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So last one is 5. Okay. Now, HCF of A and B. So 1 and 1. What is HCF? 1 and 1? 1. 1 and 2. What is HCF? Is 1. 1 and 3? 1. 1 and 4? 1. 1 and 5? 1. HCF is 1. 2 and 1. HCF is 1. 2 and 2, HCF is 2. 2 and 3, HCF is 1. 2 and 4, HCF is 2. 2 and 5, HCF is 1. Okay. 3 and 1, HCF is 1. 3 and 2, HCF is 1. 3 and 3, HCF is 3. 3 and 4, HCF is 1. 3 and 5, HCF is 1. 4 and 1, HCF is 1. 4 and 2, HCF is 2. 4 and 3, HCF is 1. 4 and 4, HCF is 4. 4 and 5, HCF is 1. 5 and 1 HCF is 1, 5 and 2 HCF is 1, 5 and 3 HCF is 1 and 1 and 5 is HCF. Okay, so now you can see this table and the fourth problem table, it is same or not. See the condition, table, this both the tables you verify it now. 1. All the first elements are 1, then second elements 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, and 1, 1, 3, 1, 1, then 1, 2, 1, 4, 1, and 1, 1, 1, and 5. So both are what? Similar. So we observe that the composition table is same as the table given in the exam exercise, what, 5th one and 4th one. So both are the same. Okay, thus what is the conclusion we can write? What is the justification? Thus star dash is equals to star. Thus star dash is equals to star. Why? So both the operations are same. So both the tables gets same answer. No, that's why it is same. So now next question. Sixth question I'll take. Let star be the binary operation on N. It's given by the star A star B is equals to LCM of A and B. Be a binary operation and justify. LCM of A and B. So we have to find some 5 questions are there in that. First question is 5*7 and 20*16. Okay. So 5*7. LCM of A and B we have to check. So what is the LCM of this? HCF is over. And now we have to check whether it is LCM of this. Okay. LCM of A and B. Now 5 and 7. 5*7 is LCM of 5 and 7. So LCM of 5 and 7 is 5 into 7 equals how much? It is 35. Okay. Now 20*16. It is LCM of 20 and 16 is. So 20 and 16 LCM we have to find. What about the 20 and 16 LCM? So 20 can be written as 2 tens, then 2 5s. 16 can be written as 2 8s, 2 4s. Right. So which are the terms we have to multiply it? 2 into 2 into 5 into 4. So how much? 4 to 8, 8 is 80. Okay, 8 tens 80. So LCM is what? 80. Then SF is what? 80. Now in the second question, we have to check star is a commutative. Star is commutative. How can you check whether star is a commutative or not? Yes. Now here you got that LCM of 5 and 7 is 35. What about the LCM of 7 and 5? It is same, 35 only. LCM of 20 and 16 is 80. Then what is LCM of 16 and 20? It is 80. Therefore star is commutative. Why it is commutative? Because A star B is equal to B star A. Okay, so simple example here only it is there, I give one. Okay. Now next third one is star is associative. Star is associative. We have to check now. So star is associative means LCM we have to check. So star is associative means LCM we have to check. So how to check that LCM? Now A star B star C. A star B star C is equals to LCM of A B C, right? Equals to what? LCM of A B and C. Now A star B star C also same, it is LCM of A B and C. There is no difference. So LCM of A B C and LCM of A B C. Therefore A star B star C equals to A star B star C. So therefore star is associative. Therefore star is associative. So clear, no? Now next fourth one in that. Find the identity of star in N. Find the identity of star in N. Identity means what? Identity element. E we have to take. If E be the identity element, E is an identity element. So you know that in the lower classes you studied E be the identity element. In that E be the identity element, A star E equals to E star A, right? E star A equals to what? A. For all A is belongs to N. A star E equals to E star A equals to what? A. So now LCM of A and E is what? LCM of A and E is A only. E is the identity element. E is the identity element. So now this implies E divides A for all A is belongs to N. It means LCM of A and E is A means E divides A for all A is belongs to N. So E divides A means E equals to what? 1 or not? E equals to 1. It means 1 divides for all the A belongs to N. Therefore, what is the identity element? Therefore, 1 is the identity element. 1 is the identity element. So E divides A for all A is belongs to N. So when E is divides all the terms of A, so only that 1. For example, 2 you take down, 2 divided by 1 is 1. If you, for example, A you take down as 3, 3 divided by 1 is 3 only. Therefore, what? 1 is the identity element. So now in that fifth question it is there. What is the fifth question? Which element of N are invertible for the operation star? Invertible. What is meant by invertible? Invertible means it's follows both the terms. In the previous exercise you studied, no, invertible. So now if A is belongs to N, if A is belongs to N, is invertible, if A is belongs to N is invertible, and B is the one more set you take down, B be the inverse of A. Okay, B be the inverse of A. It means A star B equals to B star A. It is equals to what? E. It is what? Identity element. Okay. So now A star B equals to E. This implies A star B equals to what now? 1. So E equals to 1. Already we know that 1 is the identity element. Now this implies LCM of A and B is what? 1. Okay. So LCM of A and B is what? 1. So now LCM of A and B is what? 1 means A equals to B is equals to what? 1. So only invertible elements is n equals to 1. So if A equals to B is 1 and B equals to A is 1, therefore invertible element is 1. For invertible element is 1. Okay, clear? So now next question is 7th one. Is star is defined on the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 by A star B is LCM of A and B is a binary operation and justify your answer. It is binary operation or not, we have to check. Okay, the set contains what? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, so now A star B is given, it is what? LCM of A and B. Okay. So LCM of A and B. Suppose if I am considering 3 and 4. So A equals to 3 and B equals to 4. So A star B is nothing but LCM of 3 and 4. So 3 and 4 is 12. LCM of 3 and 4 is 12. It is does not belongs to the given set, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. It is does not. Therefore, star is not a binary operation. Star is not a binary operation. So, clear. So, we have to take any one of the number that LCM is not there in the given set. Therefore, it is not a binary operation. So, now next question number, it is 8th one. Let star is a binary operation on N. Star is a binary operation on N. It is defined by A star B equals to HCF of A and B. HCF of A and B. Is star commutative? Is star associative? Does there exist identity for this binary operation on N? So, this is the question. So, for all A comma B is belongs to N, all the natural numbers, it is what N, we have to check commutative or not. It means A star B is equals to what? HCF of A and B. HCF of A and B. So, A star B is HCF of A and B, and B star A is also at HCF of B and A, right? So, B and A. Therefore, A star B is equals to B star A. What about the HCF of A and B? And what about the HCF of B and A? Both are same. Therefore, for all A comma B is belongs to what? N. Okay. Now, therefore, star is, what is the conclusion we can read? Star is commutative. So, now we have to check the associative. Associative is also what? It is the same thing only we are getting. HCF of AB and C and HCF of AB and C both are same. Therefore, star is also associative. So, how we are getting? HCF of AB and C and HCF of AB and C. It means A star B star C and A star B star C, no. So, this is what equal, that's why star is associative. If it is associative, we have to find the identity. E be the identity. You know that already I explained in the previous problem. E be the identity element. It means A star E equals to E star A for all. It is equals to what A we are getting. A is belongs to what N. Now A star E equals to A. HCF of A and E is equals to what A for all A is belongs to N. HCF of E and B means E is divisible by A or E must be a multiple of A. E is not a unique element, right? E is not a unique element. This implies E is not a unique element. It's not a unique means it's not a single element. So for example, if A equals to 2, then E equals to 2, 4, 6 and so on. So therefore, does not exist a single element. E is belongs to N. So the identity element is does not exist. So here the identity element does not exist. It means only the single element we should get. E we are getting how many elements? 2, 4, 6 and so on. The infinite elements we are getting. Okay. So here A equals to 2 we can take. A equals to 2. E is not a unique element. Why? E must be the multiple of what? E must be the multiple of A. No. E must be the multiple of A. Then only we can say it is a identity element. Here identity element does not exist. Now the question number 9th one is a very important one. We have to check whether it is a binary operation or not on the set Q. Okay. So in the first one, A star B equals to A minus B. A star B equals to A minus B. It is a commutative. A star B equals to A minus B. A minus B. B star A is equals to B minus A. So A minus B is does not equals to B minus A. You know that in that Q relation. So star is not commutative. Okay. Star is not commutative. And we have to check the associative. A star B star C equals to what is that? A minus B star C. So already I said that this is what P minus C. We have to take it as P minus C. P is A minus B minus C. Okay, this is what first case. Next, A star B minus C. So A minus of B minus C. It is A minus B plus C. Here it is 2. So now A is this and B is this. Both are not equal. Therefore star is not associative. So clear? Now next second one, A star B equals to A square plus B square. So A star B, it is a commutative. Clearly we can say it is what commutative means. B star A equals to what? B square plus A square. It is a commutative. Now we have to check the associative, whether it is associative or not. A star B star C. I am checking first these two. A square plus B square star C. Okay, now this is for C, P square plus C square. Okay, so now P is A square plus B square whole square plus C square. Okay, so now A star B star C, these are the two stars. Now A star of B square plus C square. And now this is what C, A plus B square plus C square whole square. So these are not equal. Therefore, star is not associative. Okay. So this means it is not associative. This is what right mark is commutative. Okay. So now, so third one you check yourself. So here third one, it is not a commutative. third one, a plus ab, a plus ab, it is not commutative, okay, it is not commutative and it is not a associative also, you check it, okay. This is both are not associative and not commutative, so you have to check. And third, fourth one, a star b equals to a minus b whole square. So a star b equals to a minus b whole square and b star a equals to b minus a whole square. So both are equal, therefore it is what? Commutative. Therefore it is a commutative. Now we have to check with the associative. Associative is a star b star c. So I am taking these two first. A minus b whole square star c. So now it is what? P minus c whole square. So p is a minus b minus c whole square. A minus b minus c whole square. This is square whole square. Okay, a minus b whole square minus c square. So a minus b whole square is a minus b whole square to the power of 4 minus c square you are getting. Next, a star b star c, it is a star b minus c whole square. This becomes what? P. Now this becomes what? P. So it means a minus b whole square, it is a minus of b minus c whole square whole square. It is a square minus b minus c whole to the power of 4. A square minus b minus c to the power of 4. But we cannot write like this. So this you can take only this way. A minus b whole square minus a whole square, and this is what? A minus b of b minus a whole square. These both are not equal, okay. So these both are not equal. Otherwise you can apply that a minus b whole square identity. A minus b whole square identity we have to apply it. So a minus b whole square minus c square minus 2 a minus b whole square, then into c we are getting, okay. So now this also what? 2 into a into b minus a whole square, then plus b minus 4 whole square. So clearly we can say these are not equal, no? These are not equal, therefore star is not associative. Star is not associative, okay. So now next fourth one, sorry fifth one, a star b equals to a b by 4. A B by 4. So you can check this one, A star B divided by 4. This is one of the associative and commutative. Okay. So this fourth, fifth one is associative as well as commutative. Both are same. Associative and commutative. So now I will explain the sixth one for you. A star B equals to A B square. A star B equals to A B square, then B star A equals to A square B. No? Means b a square, okay, or a square b. So a b square and b a square both are not equal, therefore it is not a commutative, okay. So now a star b star c associative we have to check. Associative is a b square star c, a b square star c. This one I'm considering it as p, p star c. P star c means p c square, it means a b square c square. Okay, AB square, C square. Now next, A star, B star, C, this one. A star, B star, C means BC square. Now A star, this is what I can consider it as P. So AP square, AP square. So now A is this, P is BC square whole square. This is what? AB square, C to the power of 4. AB square c to the power of 4 and AB square c square. So here it's both are equal. No, it's both are not equal. So ab square c square and ab square c to the power of 4. Understood now this one, how we are writing? So this term can be written as p, and p square, ap square we are getting, p is pc square like this. So star is not associative. Star is not associative. Okay. So the 9th question is over. Now 10th one. Find which of the operation can be the above has identity. So in that all the 9th question, all 6 are we simplified. No, in that which of the operations given above is has identity. So we have to check which has identity now. So which term has identity? So you know that identity for the first one, it is A star B equals to A minus B. A minus B means identity element is what? E, we have to consider it. A star E equals to E star A is equals to what? A for all A is belongs to Q. Okay. Now A star E equals to A. But the condition is what? This one A minus B. A minus E equals to A. A minus E equals to A. This implies E equals to 0 or not. So A get cancelled. This implies E equals to 0. So and E star A equals to A. So E minus A equals to A. E equals to 2A. So now I am getting E equals to 0 and E equals to 2A. Two answers we are getting for all A is belongs to Q. Which is not possible. It is possible only A equals to 0. It is possible only A equals to 0. Hence, identity element is does not exist. Okay. So, now in the second case, A star B equals to A square plus B square. Now, the identity element is E. We have to consider it. A star E equals to E star A equals to A. It means A square plus E square equals to A. Okay, A square plus E square equals to A. And E square plus A square equals to A. So, this case and this case equals to A. So, now A square plus E square equals to E square plus A square. The both answers are what? A. Okay. So, A square equals to A, it is not possible. Is it possible? It is not possible. This is what A square plus E square equals to E square plus A square equals to A. So, A square equals to A we are getting. So, now it is what? Not possible. Therefore, it's also there is no identity element. So, now third one, we'll check third one, whether identity element is there or not. A star B equals to A plus AB, no? A plus AB, okay. So now, A star E equals to E star A equals to what? A. It means A plus AE equals to E plus AE equals to what? A. Now, A plus AE equals to A and E plus AE equals to A. So AE get cancelled here. What we are getting? AE equals to 0. It means E equals to 0 in this case. Now the other side E equals to E, take it as outside the common, 1 plus A equals to A. So E equals to A divided by 1 plus A. E equals to A divided by 1 plus A and E equals to 0. This both 2 are there. That's why it is also not a identity element. There is no identity element for the third one also. Okay. Now, on the fourth one, we will check whether we are getting identity element or not. A star B equals to A minus B whole square. Okay. So, now A star E equals to E star A. It is equals to A. Now, A minus E whole square equals to E minus A whole square equals to A. So, So e minus a whole square equals to a, and a minus a whole square equals to a. Okay, so what we are getting now? A minus a whole square equals to a, and e minus a whole square equals to a. So a minus e equals to plus or minus a, and e minus a equals to plus or minus a. Okay, so now here getting e equals to 0 and e equals to 2a, the same thing, which is not true. So same, the first type we are getting, first here it is, no, the same way we are getting. So does not exist. All the four problems are not exist. Now fifth one, a star b equals to ab by 4. We have to check now. Yes, maybe here we are getting the identity element. A star E equals to E star A equals to A. It means AE divided by 4 equals to EA divided by 4 equals to A. Okay. So now AE divided by 4 equals to A or EA divided by 4 equals to A. So AE equals to 4A and AE equals to 4A. AA get cancelled. So E equals to 4. E equals to 4. So E equals to 4. Only one answer. E equals to 4 we got. Yes. Therefore, 4 is the identity element. 4 is the identity element. So clear, no? So first problem, second, third one and fourth one, it is not possible. Why? We have to E values. T equals to 0 equals to 2A. E equals to 0 equals to 2A. A square equals to A we are getting here. Okay. So now E equals to 0 and E equals to A divided by 1 plus A. So now last one we will check. Understood, Najala? Yes. So AB square we have to check. A star E equals to E star A equals to A. Now here what we can write. A into E square equals to A into A square equals to what? A into E square equals to E into A square equals to A. So now A E square equals to A and E A square equals to A. So E square E equals to 1 we are getting, and E equals to 1 divided by A. Once again it is not possible. So there is no identity element exist for sixth one also. So only one term, one binary operation is gets identity element, that is what? Fifth one, the answer is 4. Okay, so now 11th one we will simplify. Now let A equals to n into n, then star is a binary operation on A is defined by A comma B star C comma D equals to A plus C comma B plus D. Okay, so this type of problems will simplify it in the previous example also. In that we have to check whether that is a reflexive or not, or equivalence relation or not. Now we have to check whether it is a binary operation or not. Okay, so now given that it is what? A comma B star C comma D equals to A plus C comma B plus D. This is our given thing. First we have to check the commutative. So commutative, whether it is applied or not. A comma B star C comma D equals to A plus C comma B plus D. Okay, so now this can be written as C plus A comma D plus B, no? C plus A comma D plus B also we can write. A plus C can be written as C plus A. B plus D can be written as D plus A. This implies what is that? C comma D is star with A comma B or not. Therefore, what is that? This implies this and this both are equal now. Star is commutative. commutative, clear? So A plus C can be written as C plus A, and B plus D can be written as D plus D. A plus C comma B plus D is A star B C star A. This can be written as C comma D star A comma B, we can write. So it is what? Commutative. Next we have to check the associative. A comma B star C comma D. One more term we have to take, it was star E comma F. Okay, E comma F. So now how can we write this? This bracket term we can be written as A plus C comma B plus D. B plus D star E comma F we can write. So now here A plus C plus E we can write, no? Plus E we can write, comma, B plus D plus F we can write. So this term is from here and this term is from here, E and F we can add it. So now I am taking A is the other part plus these two terms I am grouping now, C plus E I am grouping, and B I am taking it outside plus D plus F I am grouping. Okay, if I am grouping like this, how can I write A comma B, okay, star, C plus E, comma D plus F or not? Okay, A comma B, this one, star, C plus E and B comma F I can write. Now for this A comma B, star, C plus E and D plus F means we can write C comma D star E comma F. E comma F. So now these two are the bracket. These two are the bracket. So now this is associative properties holds or not? Yes, associative properties holds. That implies star is associative. Star is associative. You can write like this. So now, once this is associative and commutative is over, the continuation of the question is find the identity element for star is on A. So these two are proved, star is commutative and star is associative proved. Now we have to find the identity element. So identity element, we have to take it as let E1 and E2 is belongs to what? N. E1 and E2 is belongs to what? N. Is an identity element A comma B is belongs to A. So A comma B, how can I write? Star E1 E2, this equals to E1 E2 star A comma B equals to what we have to get? A comma B we have to get. You know that. A star E equals to E star A equals to what? A we are writing. So here it is what? Like this we have to write. Now A comma B and this one is A plus E1 first term and second one. That's B plus E2 equals to E1 plus A comma sorry. E2 plus B equals to A comma B. Okay, so A comma B. Now, this both A plus E1, A plus E1 equals to A. Okay, so now B plus E2 equals to B. No, why means A plus E1 and E1 plus A both are same. B plus E2 and E2 plus B is both are same. It is what B. So E1 equals to what we got now? 0 we got. And E2 also what we got as a 0. So E1 is equals to 0 and E2 is equals to 0, which is not possible. Why? Which is not possible. But it's equal, which is not possible. Why? E1 and E2 is does not belongs to N. The condition is what? N. Okay, so if R is given, the identity element is there, we can write. But E1 and E2 is does not belongs to N, therefore it does not have any, identity element. Okay, so now second 12th problem, I'll explain to you. state whether the following statement is true or false and justify. The first question is, for an arbitrary binary operation star on a set N, A star A equals to A for all N. So arbitrary element, this statement is true or false. This statement is false. Why? A star A equals to A is for all A. Okay, arbitrary binary operation. A star A is A. It means let star be positive, then A plus A equals to A. So 1 plus 1 equals to what? 2. Then, so A plus A equals to what? 2A. 2A equals to A. Is it possible? It is not possible, which is not true. Okay, so for example, you can consider A star A equals to A, no? So under condition addition I am taking, A plus A equals to A, it is 2A equals to A, get cancelled, 2 equals to 1. Is it possible? No, it is not possible. Therefore, 2 equals to 1, it is possible, it's not possible. Therefore, it is false statement. Now the second one is, star is a commutative binary operation on A star B star C plus C star B star A. B star C star A, it's a commutative. Yes, it is what? True. Yes, same thing, you know that A star B star C and B C star B star A. So we will get the same result. So here you can see A star B star C and C star B star C. So bracket and other things, everything is same from the here. So commutative all properties already it holds. So therefore the statement is true. Okay. Now next last MCQ problem. A cube plus B cube, which is the correct answer? We have to check. So A star B is equal to A cube plus B cube. First we have to check whether it is a commutative or not, or associative or not. We have to check now. A star B equals to A cube plus B cube. Then B star A equals to B cube plus A cube. Yes, it is a what? Commutative. It is a what? Commutative. Now we have to check with the associative. A star B star C equals to A star of B cube plus C cube. Next A star P, it is A cube plus B cube. It is what? A cube plus P is B cube plus C cube whole cube. Okay. Now next A star B star C. No need to further simplify it. You will get the answer now. A cube plus B cube star C. So it is P star C now. It is P cube plus C cube. So it is what? A cube plus B cube whole cube plus C cube. Here A cube is outside. Here C cube is outside. So this is not associative. So this is commutative but not associative. So which option is the correct option? It is not associative but it is a commutative. So B option, star is commutative but not associative. Okay, so I hope that this binary operation all of you clear to you. So in the next video I will explain miscellaneous examples, important, only important examples I will explain in the miscellaneous example. Okay, thank you.